Welcome guys, welcome to Onlineopedia. In this video I'll discuss why shunt motor does not operate on AC but series motor can run on AC. So let's start it. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe our channel and do share with your friends. Thank you. Let's start it. So this is your series motor and this is your shunt motor. So this is your series motor circuit and this is your shunt motor circuit. Okay, and B, and in the circuit B is your terminal voltage or supply voltage. Or you can say supply voltage. This is your armature and this is your armature. EB is your back EMF. RA is your armature resistance. Okay, and RS is your shunt field resistance and RSC is your series field resistance. Okay, now for series motor, if you look at the circuit carefully, then you can find that this current and this current is equal. That is, you can write IL is equal to ISC is equal to IA because all these are in series. Okay, so for series, the current remains same. So the load current is equal to series field current, or you can say this is your armature current. This is for series motor. But for shunt motor, if you apply KCL here, you will get IL is equal to ISH plus IA because incoming current is equal to the outgoing current. So these two are outgoing and this is your incoming current. Okay, and for series motor, this is your KCL. Okay, now if you apply KVL inside the loop, you will get V is equal to EB plus IA into RA for this and IA into RAC for this resistance. Okay, and in the same way, if we apply KVL here, you will get V is equal to EB plus IA RA. Okay, so this is number one equation for shunt motor. This is number two. This is number one, and this is number two. Or you can summarize it like EV is equal to IA into RA plus RAC. Okay, now one thing you should remember that RA is very low. Okay, compared to RAC and RSH. Okay, now RAC is also very low compared to RSH. Okay, and this is the hierarchy. Okay, RA is very less than RAC and RAC is very less than RSH. Okay, now for DC series motor or shunt motor, in generally for DC motor or DC generator, we know that generated EMF or back EMF is equal to PN phi Z divided by 60A. So N is your speed in RPM because these are necessary to derive the function. Okay, that is why DC series motor is operated on AC and shunt motor is does not operate on AC, to show you the exact reason these formulas are necessary. So this is why I derive it. Okay, so N is your speed in RPM, P is your number of poles, and Z is your number of conductors, and A is your number of parallel paths. Okay, and phi is your flux per pole. Okay, so back EMF is Pn phi z by 60. And one thing you should know that omega, that is also speed in radian per second. This is in radian per second. And this is in RPM. Okay. Now, omega can be written as 2 pi n by 60. Okay. So, from this equation, I can write n is equal to 60 omega divided by 2 pi. Clear? Now, if I put the value of n in the equation of Eb, I'll get Eb is equal to P phi z divided by 60A into, for this n, I can write 60 omega divided by 2 pi. Now, if you cancel it 60 and 60, you will get P phi z omega by 2 pi into A. Okay. Now, from this, you can find the constants. That is, for a particular machine, the number of poles and the number of conductors and the parallel path remain constant. Only the variable things are phi and omega, that is speed and flux. So I can write Pz by 2 pi A into omega phi. Okay. So therefore, I can write Eb is equal to, so these are constant elements, so I can use K instead of this. This is constant, okay, and omega phi. So for a DC motor, the back EMF can be written as K phi omega. Okay, so this is one equation. And the relation between, next is the relation between power and torque. Okay, so the relation between power and torque is P is equal to T omega. P is equal to T into omega. Okay, so P is your power, developed power, T is your developed torque, and omega is your speed. So from this equation, I can find torque is equal to P by omega. And for developed torque, it would be for DC motor, Eb into Ia. Power is your Eb into I, okay, and omega remains same. So we know that Eb is your K phi omega. So if I put K phi omega into Ia by omega, then omega omega cancelled, then you will get K phi into I. So this is your torque equation, that is K T is equal to K phi into I. So this is your torque equation. So these two equations are necessary, okay, for DC machine calculation. Now, for series field, we know that Ia is equal to IL is equal to IAC for series motor. Okay. And we also getting that, we also get that T proportional to phi into Ia for DC motor. Now, the field produced for this series motor is due to this armature current, because this series current and armature current is same, because Ia is equal to IAC. So I can write phi is directly proportional to IAC, because the flux produced in this winding is due to this current, that is your IAC. And as IAC is directly proportional to Ia, IAC is equal to Ia, so I can write IAC is equal to Ia. So phi proportional to Ia. Therefore, the torque in series motor, I can write T proportional to Ia into Ia, or I can write T proportional to Ia square. So this is the main fundamental thing, that is T proportional to Ia square. That is, the torque produced in series motor is directly proportional to the armature current square. So this is why The series motor can operate on AC and DC, but shunt motor cannot. So if I draw the torque waveform with respect to armature current, then you may get the clear idea. So this is your armature current, which is AC in nature. Okay, positive cycle, negative cycle, positive. As the torque is directly proportional to Ia square, so if I write Ia, sorry, torque here. Now, for positive cycle, the torque would be positive because T proportional to Ia square. If I put Ia is equal to 2, so for this it would be 2, and for this it would be minus 2. So for positive cycle, the torque would be like this, 4. Because Ia square, if Ia is 2, then it would be 4. For negative cycle, it would be minus 2 square. So minus 2 square means also 4, that is positive. That means for negative cycle, you getting positive torque, and for positive cycle, you also getting positive torque. That is, you are getting unidirectional torque for series motor. Okay. So this is the reason that series motor can operate on AC and DC also. Okay. So this is the main thing. Okay. This is the main equation that clarifies that DC series motor can operate on AC as well as DC. Okay. T proportional to I square. Okay. So now for shunt motor, the same equation exists, T proportional to phi into I. But for shunt machine, flux is constant. Phi is equal to flux, that is constant. Because this voltage, V is constant, supply voltage is constant, and the shunt current, ISH, is equal to V by RSH, because this voltage, is nothing but this point voltage, this node voltage is V, and for this current ISH, I can write this node voltage divided by the shunt. As the supply current is fixed, supply voltage is fixed, that means the shunt current is also fixed. If shunt current is fixed, then we know that the flux, field flux is directly proportional to the shunt current. So as the shunt current is fixed, I can say the field flux is constant. If field flux is constant, therefore I can write torque is directly proportional to Ia because phi is constant, so I can avoid this. So for DC shunt motor, the torque is proportional to armature current. Okay. So for DC shunt motor, the torque is proportional to armature current. Now if I draw the waveform of torque and armature current, this is your AC armature current. Okay. This is your armature current and this is your torque. For positive, negative, positive. As torque is directly proportional to I, for positive current, the torque is positive, and for negative it will be negative, same this. So it is bi-direction, because for positive cycle you are getting a positive torque, and for negative cycle you are getting a negative torque. That is why when you apply AC on shunt motor, the motor start vibrating. Because the torque is bidirectional, sometime it will move like this, sometime it will move like this. Okay, so it will vibrate, it will never start. Okay, but for DC series motor, as the torque is proportional to armature current square, then for positive cycle as well as for negative cycle, the torque is positive, unidirectional. But for shunt motor, T is proportional to I. Therefore, T is bidirectional. Okay, that means it is not starting, it will vibrate and it will never start on AC supply. But DC series motor can operate on AC supply. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to share with your friends.